Hello, my name is Carly.
My name is Mia.
Hello.
I'm Maya.
And I'm a triplet.
This one, I mean, you can just on your little swing, Carly, so happy. Yeah, you're all just so happy. You were such good babies. And I would feel bad that I couldn't always play with you individually the way I wanted to, because there was just always one was going this way, one was going that way, and the other one was going the other way. Yeah, you kids were very happy. You know, you were. This was every morning. Let me get this open. Every morning, you would just come get in our bed, and we would have like little morning parties, and that was one of the best parts of my day.
How did I feel when I found out we were having triplets? It's always a state of shock. But at the same time, it was a sense of, we felt a little bit better. We thought something was wrong. So when we found out, they were doing a pretty in-depth level 2 ultrasound because they thought something was wrong. So when they told us, oh, no, it's not that there is something wrong. It's that we didn't factor in that there's more than one baby. You guys are having 3 babies. So, you know, so at the same time, even though it was a little shock, it was a relief knowing that that there was nothing wrong with the baby.
So I was very sick when I was pregnant, before I knew I was having the girls. And the doctor, I took a blood test to see what was going on, because something was wrong. My blood levels were elevated, not normal. So they gave me a Down syndrome, you know, they checked for Down syndrome and spina bifida, and the spina bifida test came back positive, meaning that the one baby I thought that I was pregnant with had a very high chance of having spina bifida, which is very scary and terrifying. So I went and had a 4D ultrasound with a specialist, and I was already really emotional because I thought my baby was extremely sick. And then the nurse just asked me, how, you know, she just said, you have more than one in there. You have more than one baby. And I was really excited because I always wanted twins. And then she's like, well, there's more than two. And then my husband stood up and, what? In the chair, and I shot up, and I just tears, because I knew in that moment my life just changed. I'm going from 1 child to 4, and they're gonna be really small. Like, I hope that I can keep them healthy.
I feel bad. There's people in the car.
It's literally me and Joe, and don't feel bad.
What? Why? Why are you laughing? What? What?
Hello, I'm Carlo. I'm Mia, Maya, and Carly's older brother. So what's it like to be an older brother to triplets? Well, don't know where to start. I feel like it's very much keeping up with the Kardashians. There's never a dull moment. I do feel like we need our own personal camera crew to follow us around and keep up with our drama. But overall, I feel like it's been really fun, and I don't know what I would do without them. I do hair, so I feel like growing up, I really needed them to able to like practice or try a new hairstyle on them, and they were always willing to let me do that. So I'm super grateful to have them for that. But overall, it's been a really fun, yeah, it's really fun. I feel like there's just never a dull moment.
I think our relationship is mostly positive. I mean, we fight, obviously, but when we're around other people, it can be positive and negative because people take our conversations and our banter with each other as like really evil toward each other. Not like evil, but you know, like that we're constantly fighting, and it's really annoying for like, you know, that's just how we show our love for each other, is we're constantly like making fun of each other, teasing each other, having like funny conversations, and then like 3 seconds later we're like laughing about it or watching a show. And some people just can't handle that amount of energy. Which I understand, it is a lot, but I hate it when people think that we have a terrible relationship because we're constantly fighting all the time. So I feel like that is how it affects others around us, because it can come off as like a negative. I will say it's probably weird for people around us because I just feel like it's hard to understand our relationship with each other. Like, 1 second we are screaming at each other, literally saying like, I'm gonna smack you in the face. And then 3 seconds later we're literally dying laughing over, I have no idea. Just, it's a really odd relationship that a majority of people don't understand. So I can say it's, could be funny for others around us, it could be weird, it could be a little, I don't know, just like weird to watch, I guess.
I love season one
not that long
ago. Well, too bad.
I'll do 2 through 4
of you. If we're gonna rewatch Stranger Things, you have to start from the beginning.
Yeah, that's kind of tragic.
I don't know if these are like assumptions, but people like knowing that I'm a triplet might just be like, oh, like, I feel like they might just assume that like I'm not independent, which yeah, in certain cases I'm not, because I am used to having them, but that's not true. Like I'm still my own individual person, and there are certain things I do like to do alone, just like there are certain things I would like to have them with me for, but I feel like people assume that like I can't do things alone sometimes, or they don't see me as an individual. Like always like, oh my god, are you guys twins? No, we're triplets. And then I'm always like, yeah. Or I distinctly remember this in my brain. Some girl, one of my mom's friends, was like, and you must be their friend. Because I think I look nothing like them, but some people say that I kind of, like at work, some people are like, oh yeah, you and your sister kind of look similar, but I see no resemblance whatsoever. So I'm not surprised when people are like, oh yeah, are you their friend? And I'm like, no, I'm the third triplet. So sometimes I kind of feel left out because most people are always like, oh my god, are you guys twins? And I'm just like, you know. We're all individuals. We're all different people. And it's just, I don't like it when people will say like, I know a lot of people don't do it intentionally, but they just will assume that we're all on the same page, we're all agreeing on the same thing, we all have the same ideas, we all have the same interests, we all like want to do the same thing, which isn't true, because we are individuals, and people forget that a lot of the time. We're 3 different people. Yes, we are triplets, and we're obviously really close, we're with each other all the time, but we are still 3 different people, and I think that's one of the things that bothers me, and I know it bothers Maya and Carly too, but I don't know. Yeah.
Do I feel closer to one of them? Well, I feel like I personally see myself the most in Maya, and that is why me and her can be a little closer sometimes, because we just have a lot of the similar ways of thinking and just like our energy. And I literally, like, she's my mini-me. Like, I always call her my mini-me. She's like my twin. She's me if I was a girl, and I'm her if she was a boy. So I feel like I am the a little more closer to her just because I see myself most in her. But I go through phases. I feel like there's some times where I'm a little more like, me and Carly have our moments, me and Mia have our moments, but yeah.
Mia is kind of a more understanding person than Carly. Like, sometimes, no, like Mia does get mad easily. But if I am actually like upset about something, Mia will help me. She's the type of person to, like, she just will help me and she'll listen, and I feel like she just knows what to say that'll help me feel better. Whereas if I feel like if I'm truly upset about something, Carly just will not say the right thing sometimes. And she also tends to like have a loud mouth, so I don't really trust certain things I tell her. So I don't really go to her for certain.
Epcot.
Maya.
Am I happy, please?
Yes, I do think that I'm closer to one sister. And I don't mean it as like, I love one sister over the other. Like, obviously I love them both equally. I both care about them. They're both my sisters. And I wouldn't be here without them. But Maya and I share a lot more interests, so I bond with her a lot more. Like, it's pretty obvious. Like, Carly is a singer. She does theater. She's done that. That's just her thing. But my thing is, like, sports and stuff and basketball and not even just our interests, just our personalities. We are just different. Carly's funny and quirky and doesn't know when to stop joking a lot of the time. And me, on the other hand, I know I get aggressive and I know I get mad. And sometimes those don't combine well. But I do feel like Maya just understands me a little better. But Mia is very loud and strong. I mean, I'm just as loud, probably twice as loud, but she's very strong and very, I don't know, what's the word I'm looking for? She's very aggressive. And which can be good and bad. Sometimes it's funny, sometimes it's not funny. And also, I think it's partly just because Mia and I, she's athletic, I'm artistic, so it's just like, we don't really have a lot to bond over. I feel like Maya and I have a lot of inside jokes and things like that, and Mia and I like barely have anything. Maybe like one or two things. Because I feel like Mia and I are just, it's just based off what we're interested in. And I just feel like, obviously I'm gonna love her, I'm gonna care about her, she's my sister, but I feel like there's a little bit missing from our relationship because we like completely different things. Because obviously people are gonna have their own opinions. And yeah, sometimes that will get to me or frustrate me, but at the end of the day, like, it's just what people think. It's just an opinion. Like, we know who we are, we know what's best for us, we know what we want. Like I already kind of said, it does get frustrating when people lump us together as one or throw in their opinions of, oh, you guys should separate. Like, you guys are getting, you guys are gonna depend on each other a lot. Maybe you should go to different colleges. Maybe you should do this. Maybe you should do this. Oh, you guys are gonna be together for the rest of your lives, aren't you? Like, that makes me mad because I'm just like, how does that affect you? Like, that frustrates me because people don't understand our relationship with each other.
Look at all of this.
So I know the triplets because they're my best friends, and I met Mia first a long time ago, around sixth grade. Me and Mia, well, I met all of them in sixth grade. I've known them since sixth grade, but me and Mia were the closest in sixth grade, and I feel like just recently I got close with the other two.
I know the triplets through my work in theater. They have all been performers on the stage. And I met them, I can't remember the year, but they were in third grade. It was during The Little Mermaid Junior. And the three of them came in and auditioned. And I said, triplets, well, I have to put them in the same roles because, you know, triplets. And so they were Ursula's tentacles, and they were dancers in several of the ocean water numbers. And yeah, those are the roles we put. Oh. And Carly and Maya were the boat. And Carly didn't like to hold it up well. So Maya had like the whole boat on one end. It was very funny.
No. When we were growing up, I feel like I was closer with Mia just because we bonded through basketball and that's what we had in common. And I didn't really know the other two that well. So it definitely was Mia. But the thing that brought us the closest, the reason that I am their quadruplet, is because I got the chance to know the other two too and to see like how amazing they all really are. I'm definitely not closer with any of them. I know Carly likes to think that we're not as close, but that's not true. I love Carly. I feel like Carly is my little sister too. They're all my little sisters, and I'm not closer with any of them.
So I've had the privilege to know them for so long that I've really gotten a feel for their personalities and who they are as individuals. And there's actually, other than appearances, there's not a lot of similarities. Starting with Mia, she is very athletic and very sports driven and has been for a while. She started in the theater and she's very good at it and very talented at it, but sports were the range she went for a long time. She did come back for her senior show and we were very glad to have her back. But I think that is, not that that's her personality, but that is what kind of sets her apart, is that she has that athletic ability and uses it in athletics. Maya is somebody who really focuses on what they need to do. And I'm primarily speaking from the theater aspect in terms of work ethic, because I don't truly know their work ethic outside of it. I know them as people outside of it, but not how they operate or what they work and how they work. But in the theater, she is very much in control of what she wants to do. She values people's opinions, but she doesn't necessarily rely on them. But she's very focused on her characters and creating those. And then Carly is one who has a personality of her own. She's got a style of her own. She really doesn't like mold with anybody, and it carries through in her performances, it carries through in her work ethic, and I think that's what separates them personally.
Okay, so I feel like Mia is more strong-willed. I feel like she takes initiative a lot. I feel like she gets things done. She's very assertive. She's more fiery. She's the most fiery one out of the three of them. So I feel like that's Mia. And then Maya is more gentle, more caring, more emotion driven. She just has a very like gentle, welcoming presence and energy to her. She's very comforting to go to. I was gonna say I feel like she's creative, but they're all creative in their own way. Carly is more of an old soul. She's very free-flowing, go with the flow, like very hippie vibes. She listens to different music than we all do, and that's what makes her her. She's very sure of who she is as a person, whereas I feel like me and Maya are still kind of figuring that out, which is fine. But yeah, like Carly is just such an old soul.
Back to the beginning when I was talking about how we communicate with each other, it's very aggressive banter and it sounds like we're fighting, but that's just how we show our love for each other. It's just like, you're stupid, shut up. But like, if you aren't my sister, if you weren't related to me, and you say, shut up, I'm just like, stop. I don't, like, that makes me not like you. And I mean, maybe for a second, but I just hate how people constantly think that the people are just like, stop arguing. Like, you guys have a terrible relationship. Like, you have no idea what it's like to be a sister. Like Carly is a strong singer, and I feel like a lot of people know that, but sometimes they're like, Carly's a good singer. No one has ever said Carly's the better singer, but sometimes like it's comparing and like people's opinions and talking about Carly singing so much, and I'm just like, okay, like I sing too. It's not like just Carly, and I feel like so being compared, and like Mia is very athletic, and even our family, like they're just like, Mia's so strong. Like she's so athletic. Talk about all her basketball accomplishments, how strong she is, and I'm just like, okay, like I get it. Like I feel like that's what kind of is annoying about being in the middle is like, Carly's a singer, theater's her thing, and Mia is athletic, basketball's her thing, and I'm just like, I feel like I never really had my moment because those were both their things. So I was just in the middle, and I never really got praise for either of them I don't want to be dramatic. Not that I never got praise, but Mia and Carly just got more. And so I feel like that used to kind of annoy me because I feel like being in the middle, I would just get left out sometimes.
Maya's word would be selfless. And I don't think that's a word that a lot of people might associate off the top of their head, just base knowledge. But I watch her go out of her way when something's seriously going on. I've watched her go out of her way to comfort Carly. I've watched her go out of her way to be there for her cast members. I've watched her put them before her in terms of like getting ready to go on stage. Well, she's not going to focus on that because they're not in the right headspace. So she's going to help them get in the headspace and then she's going to go. And she's still going to do it well. And I recently learned during Alibis that she leads affirmations before the shows. I had no idea. This has been apparently going on for years. And sometimes it's three of them sitting in a little circle doing affirmations. And for Alibis, I walked in on a dressing room full of my entire cast of 20 doing affirmations. But Carly, and I think several others lead those, or not Carly, Maya and several others lead those. But Maya, I think, is the driving force behind it because she's recently been reminding me of my own affirmations. It never fails, whatever show, whatever vision I have in my head, she has some way to update it so that it's not what I had in my head, but somehow it ends up working the right way. And I think that's something we have always joked about and it's always happened, but I don't think I realized the collaboration it was and what it was throughout.
Our second senior, Mia DeJesus. Woo! Escorted by Paris Megan and Carlos DeJesus. Mia's accomplishments include girls' golf and varsity basketball. Her favorite memories when she scored her first varsity point freshman.
Sports like basketball, that's like the main thing that I'm really alone with. Maya and Carly have no interest in basketball, so I'm really kind of left alone there. And not that they aren't, like, they don't help me through it. They obviously do, like, and even if they don't understand where I'm coming from or what I'm saying, they will always help me feel better about the situation and always tell me what I need to hear. And being alone like that is just weird for me. It's weird not having them there. Sometimes something will happen at like basketball and I'm like, I can't wait to go home and tell Maya and Carly this. And that comes along with a lot of anxiety. And I'm also really quiet in basketball because I feel like it's because I don't have them there with me. But being alone like that for several years, playing that sport by myself, I associate it with a lot of anxiety and loneliness. And they were always there to help me though. They are always been there to help me through. When I come home, if I had a bad day, they're always there to like talk me through it. They give me the best advice. They're just always there for me. Like, it's hard for me to explain it, but they are.
Mia's word would be independent. I feel like it's not the word that I think she would associate with herself or that other people would associate with her, but I look at them as a family unit. They're triplets. They were born on the same day. They grew up together. But Mia didn't stick and do the same things that the other two did. And that's where I think she would be independent. And I think that's not for better, for worse, for negative, for positive, but independent would be the word I would use, because she was able to do her own thing and not feel guilty about it. And I think, as far as I know, because they never shared it with me, but the other two didn't guilt her about it until senior year, when they were like, hey, you better do this. And she was like, I want to do it. So it worked out. But yeah, I think independent would be the word I would use for Mia.
Year, like sophomore, junior year, I was diagnosed with depression and anxiety, which was a huge problem, and I didn't know how to control my emotions at all. It was terrible. I didn't go to school for like a week, but at least I wasn't alone. I mean, I felt alone, but I know I wasn't, because I had my entire family cared about me, and the only people that stuck by me were my sisters. And I always say that I feel alone, and I always tell people, like, oh, I have no one, like, I'm depressed, like, I'm all by myself. But I have two other people that, for some aspects, know exactly what I'm going through. So it's nice to know that I'm not the only one who's feeling a specific way. And when I was down on myself, they always tried to make me feel better. No matter how hard I tried to push them away from me, I didn't accept support. I didn't. But they always tried their best to make me feel better, and it worked. Sometimes it didn't work. But it's just the fact that they were always there, and they never gave up on me.
What a thing to see, he appears to me.
Carly's, I hope I'm not being vulnerable for you, but Carly's anxiety and self-doubt is something that she and I have in common, but it's something that I've tried to work through with her and work with her to make it as easy as possible in terms of pre-show, during show, this, that, the other. Sometimes you need quiet space. Sometimes you need not as many people around you. And I try to be cognizant of that, but that's something that, looking back, I hope that I was able to be a mentor in that position. And that's something I've really appreciated sharing with her.
This is a vlog. What are we doing?
For who?
For future Maya.
Oh, okay.
I know it's basic, but honestly, anytime any of us have gone to Disney World together has been a really, definitely one of my favorites and sticks out my mind, is going to Disney World and being there with them. Just specific moments at Disney World. It's definitely our happiest place. We're all happier.
Wait, Jack, we're turning 18. Do you mind
18.
Telling us happy birthday?
Yeah.
All three of you?
Yes.
Your birthday's today?
Yeah.
You're all turning 18 today?
Yes. Yes.
How do you split that up evenly, eh?
I don't know.
We share everything.
You share everything?
Yes.
Well then, I might be able to impart some piratey wisdom for your 18th birthday, seeing as you're all free as an undead monkey now, and free to roam the seas as you please. I might suggest that you find the rules that you disagree with, and that you treat them a bit more like guidelines, as they were. Find your ways around them. Mm-hmm. Make sure that you raid, pillage, plunder, pilfer Weasley Black Guts out, and have fun.
We also, a really good memory that I think about, we would always put on shows for like our family. We would use like one of the rooms in our house, and we would just put on, like, we would practice, and it would be really, we would take it really seriously. We would like put on The Little Mermaid, and Carly and I would usually fight over who's gonna be Ariel. And we would like do The Little Mermaid. We would make up our own shows sometimes, and we would put them on for our parents. And my mom and my dad, they would just record it and like laugh. And They liked it, I think.
I loved that you all just sang and danced and show, and every Saturday we're gonna have a show and here's your ticket. But there were times where I was just like, this is the 8th show this week, kids, you know?
When we went sledding, we used to go sledding with our dad on this, I don't even know where it was, but it was the same place every year. We used to go sledding. And I can hear the screams if I think about it. I can hear our screams of excitement going down the hill. And I remember Mia like yelling for my dad because he was like recording us. And it was just so cute. We all had squeaky voices around. I'm like, ah! So, yeah, I always think about, if I think about a memory.
Okay, go, go.
Charlie, grab my hand!
There have been a lot of upsetting, life-changing moments in our lives the past couple months, the last year, that we have been close. And we handle them by blasting music in their living room and literally chasing each other, just doing weird dance moves, because that's what we find like entertaining. Like, we don't find it entertaining to sit there and like talk about people and like be negative. Like, we literally will blast Britney Spears and chase each other around the living room and pretend that we are in SpongeBob and give each other weird nicknames, talk to each other in weird voices, just because that's what is entertaining to us. Like, we're literally children.
Play like a violin.
That looks so cool. Like
I cast the triplets, all three of them, as spectators in the Actor Games. The Actor Games is the concept of the Hunger Games, but it's for performing arts, and it's a spoof of the Hunger Games. And the spectators were members of the Capitol who were watching the games. So Maya comes, and I pretty much let them like costume themselves, figure out their own hair and makeup, because it's supposed to be fantasy and wild, because it's mocking the Hunger Games. And Maya comes in looking like Ariana Grande. She's got ponytail up here. Did you wear gloves?
No.
Oh. In my memory, she wore gloves. I might be mixing like her prom look with Ariana Grande from sixth grade. But she had a full face of makeup. Like, I've never seen someone that young wear that much makeup. But, I mean, she looked great. She was beat for the gods, but she looked great. But she was very much like, she was the most over the top in terms of appearance in the spectators. And I just loved that about her. And then Carly took direction so well. And I said, you need to be invested in these games. You need to be invested in what's going on. You need to react to what's happening on stage. And at some point for something, I can't remember what exactly happened in the show, but all of a sudden, Carly just starts dusting her arms and shoulders off. Now, it would have been appropriate and working in order to just do that. Except she did that the whole show. Every like 2 minutes, she'd sit there and watch the thing and, oh, react, and really great. And then she'd dust herself off. Like, she sat there for a moment and got dusty. I'm not really sure on that. So that's my favorite memory of those two from the Actor Games. But my favorite memory of Mia is a recent one. She came back for Alibis, like I said, her senior show, and I cast her as the paper bag girl. And she comes up to me and she goes, I don't have to wear a paper bag on my head, right? And I was like, it's literally the paper bag girl. Yes, you do. She goes, but can I like have a reveal? And I was like, a reveal? She's like, you know, like I take the bag off and I'm like, yes, it's me. I'm beautiful. She didn't actually use those words, but that was the motions she used. And it's just one of the things I appreciate about her, and I think it's hilarious, and I think back and laugh on it, and I enjoy it.
Yes, I like being a triplet, because it's just like having two built-in best friends, like, where we just always have each other, and it's nice to always have those people to fall back on, and at the end of the day, we could be mad at each other over something stupid, but I always know that we're gonna have each other's backs when it comes down to it. I mean, I don't know if I could ever, like, not like being a triplet. I feel like I just what I'm used to. Like, I'm a triplet. I'm used to that. Which is, like, funny, because usually when we tell people that for the first time, they're like, oh, what? You're a triplet? That's insane! And to me, it's just like, yeah, we're triplets. And, so yeah, I don't think I could ever not like being a triplet. It's just what I'm used to. And I cannot imagine not being a triplet, actually. So, yeah.
I like to think everything happens for a reason. I don't, I don't think things are thrown at anybody that they can't handle. I mean, I'm glad we had triplets when we were young. Couldn't imagine doing that now. Growing up, I didn't really have any females around me except my mom. No sisters. So I really didn't know what to expect, having three girls just come into my life. I thought this was going to be a good learning experience for me. But I do feel like I've grown and learned to be a little more in touch with myself, emotions, feelings, loving. I find myself being a little more sensitive. So I got in touch with my sensitive side.
Yeah.
Feel like you were meant to have us. Like,
I knew I was meant to have you. There's definitely a reason for it. You taught me patience. You taught me, you know, I appreciate my mom more being a mom of little girls. I couldn't be more proud of the women that you are and the women that you're becoming. And this next step for you, college, living in Chicago, that's what I always wanted for you, because that's what you always wanted. And the sky's the limit. It's only just beginning, and I couldn't be more proud.
I feel like my life would just be so boring if I didn't have them, honestly. Like, if I was an only child, like, I feel like it would just be super boring and dull. And yeah, I feel like we've had so many fun experiences and moments, and like, we go to Disney World a lot, like, that's like our thing. And like, even going to Disney World without them, I feel like it just wouldn't be the same. It's not fun. Like, we have our like inside jokes, we just have our moments, and I feel like my life would just be boring. But also, I feel like going back to me doing hair, like, they were literally like my Barbie dolls. Like, I was able to like explore and practice on their hair, and I feel like I wouldn't have had that in my life. I feel like I am protective of them overall in general, but I feel like what's sticking out to me specifically right now, I feel like as of late, I've been a little more protective because they're moving to Chicago, they're moving to this big city, and in my head, I'm like, oh my god, like, they're just like little babies, like, they're moving to like a big city, like, going to venture off, and I'm just like, okay, like, I feel like my protective instincts are kicking in more now with the thought of them moving to Chicago.
No, I'll answer it. Can't promise I won't cry, but I'll answer it. Carly, Mia, and Maya have impacted my life in the way that all of my students impact my life. Not that they're not special, but my students mean the world to me, and I am someone who, as many educators and people who work in schools are, I give my everything to them and to my kids, especially my kids that are in the theater. They're my kids. And this group that's seniors right now that are with Mia, Maya, and Carly have been with me since they were very little. This is the first group I've had that's, all of them have been with me since they were really young. And I am someone, I don't have children. I won't have children of my own. And I appreciate a lot of my kids as my own children. And each of them have their own things that they do for my soul in terms of just giving me things I would never have. And specifically, there are just, there's memories and emotions and things that have gone on in the last 10 years that we've been together that I'll look back and always remember as standout moments. Those being like the biggest one in my head I can remember most recently anyway. I've never had students want me to be the first one to see something they've gotten done. Like me and Maya got a tattoo and they wanted to show me first. And I don't have that. I've never had that because I don't have my own children. And that just meant a lot to me that they cared about me enough that they wanted me to be the first one to see it. And Carly always makes me feel important and valued in when she wants my opinion or when she asks me things. And it's just, it means a lot to me.
All right, okay. All right, go.
On three, we say thanks for its enthusiasm because it takes faith to do what we do. It takes courage to get on stage and do it. And it takes enthusiasm because it's not worth doing if it's not done enthusiastically. On three. One, two, three.
No matter what, at the end of the day, we'll always have each other.